care network and how this is being set up. I think another issue when it comes to Commission Act implementation is looking at not only, you know, what are the standards that are being put in place, who are they contracting with, who are the third-party administrators to deliver these community care appointments, but how is the process going? Is there anybody in the room here that actually works on scheduling or anything related to care in the community appointments? No? Okay. One over here. Okay, thanks. So one of the things that we're hearing, I believe there was an Office of Inspector General report that touched on this as well recently, was looking at, from the point of decision between the veteran and their primary care physician, saying, hey, you need to get specialty care, right? Once that decision is made and they figure out, okay, this is going to be community care within the VA, there's a lag time between that decision and somebody in scheduling actually saying, okay, here's your appointment options for care in the community. That's, I think, in some cases, like 20 days. I think it's the longest that I've heard. Maybe it's longer, I don't know. Yeah, so even if the VA, even if they improve the access standards for these third-party administrators and their community providers, even if they improve that to be the same as the VA access standards, you still have this lag time. So the veteran's basically sitting there, the clock's not even running, and their appointment isn't getting scheduled until it gets over the right person. So those are the kind of real, on the ground, how things function. Those are the kind of issues that we didn't see that, I think, writing the bill. So now that we're in the implementation period, we need to get to the input and say, hey, this is a problem, and then make sure VA is working to fix it, right? That's not the intent, is that you can sit there for 30 days, not schedule an appointment,